Did it come out as a dog?
Probably not.
What was it?
Probably didn't come out as a mammal at all. It probably came out as a reptile and evolved that way.
So you think we lived under the water?
It's possible at some point.
When we were under the water, do you think we had lungs or gills? Because I'm trying to think, here is this sort of animal who's coming out of the ocean without lungs, so he comes out with gills, goes, runs back to water and just keeps coming out until lungs develop?
Yeah.
Wow. Now, this animal that came out was in the sea, so obviously had gills. When it came up out of the land, did it have lungs? Out of the land?
It could have either been amphibious or possibly even just had to evolve from having gills and not being able to survive without them.
So you think we may have come from birds?
It's possible. You know, it's really possible from anything.
The first dog that came out, well, it came up as a reptile, whatever it was, from an amoeba that was in the water that had gills and developed lungs and came up onto the land as a reptile, was it male or female?
Probably unisex.
So when did it and why did it change from asexual to bisexual, having male or female?
Probably when it, maybe from hydras or maybe some form of, you know, well, you know, meiosis, you know, like between a male and a female.
So the first reptile that was under the sea as an amoeba, for millions of years, developed lungs under the water, caught up on the land, was unisex?
Probably.
Probably.
Probably. I can't say for sure.
Was it a male or female that came out of the change?
It would be both, maybe hermaphroditic.
So do you think we could have evolved from horses?
Sure.
This animal that came out without lungs and breathes and went back in, was he male or female?
I don't know. Cool. He could have been a hermaphrodite.
He was male and female?
Yeah, probably.
And he was alone?
I don't know. Could have been.
So he could have been alone?
Could have been alone.
So how did he reproduce?
I don't know. Asexually.
He split in two?
He could have.
Yeah. And this is the evidence that this teacher gave you?
His is a lot more in-depth, but I don't remember it all. Sorry.
Well, I really have no idea. I'm not an expert on that subject.
But then you got to know that I'm not authoritative.
You're not an authority on evolution?
I'm a personal person, you know what I mean? Like, I, you know, with no major degree or anything.
Do you think God had anything to do with this?
That's an area I have never explored, but it's hard not to believe that sometimes.
And this continues on for another painful minute that is of comfort going and randomly interviewing college students. Now, the amazing thing about this is simply how dishonest it is. What comfort is trying to portray is that the people who are supporting evolution they don't know anything about it. And they use this language because they're really kind of clueless, and he's just stumped the evolutionists. Well, you're going around asking random college students. Seriously? I mean, that's utterly dishonest. Why don't you ask a scientist or anyone like that? Why do you have to go and ask random college students who probably don't know anything about it to try and prove your point? And keep in mind, those are the ones that he edited who actually couldn't answer his questions. I'm sure there were plenty who could that they simply didn't air. I mean, this is amazingly dishonest simply because they're meaning to make it appear as if we don't have answers to these things.
They'll end up saying things like, well, I really don't know. I'm not an expert, so what...
Geez, I wonder why they're saying that. Oh, and to basically answer his question about coming out on land, it was the arthropods who were on land first. And did they have gills or lungs? They actually had neither, because they have thin membranes, which basically allow for gas exchange via diffusion. This is actually what limited their size, which is why in the past, the oxygen content in the atmosphere was roughly 30%, which is much higher than the 20% that it is now, and we were able to see giant arthropods such as Brontoscorpio and things like that measuring several meters long as opposed to the very small size that they're restricted to today. So, as you can see, it's the percentage of oxygen in the atmosphere that limits their size, and they don't have lungs or gills. Now, moving on to fish, however, to answer his question about did they just kind of flop around or run back and take breaths and things like that, perhaps if he would take a minute to actually look at nature before producing an ignorant video, he would find his answer. There are several animals and fishes which are amphibious and can leave the water and hang out on land for a little bit of time. Take a look at mudskippers, take a look at lungfish, and plenty of things like that. The answer to his question is in nature all around us. But then again, of course, random college students that he was interviewing probably wouldn't be able to give that answer.